Hi students, welcome back to Advanced English class, second semester. Today's chapter is giving instructions. Instructions means the procedure, the process of using, utilizing any item or working in any company, doing any work. And also giving instructions means how to utilize, how to work using any item. Sometimes in these instructions you see how to behave in the classroom, how to work in a company, how to cross a road, how to open an account, how to operate a kind telephone, how to draw money from an ATM. There are number of things, sir. How to operate mobile phone, how to operate laptop. Number of things are there. So this chapter concentrates on how to give instructions. So the main objective of this lesson is understand instructions and give instructions. How to understand instructions? When you see a mobile phone or an Apple iPhone, if you don't know how to operate it, how to switch on, how to switch off, how to call, definitely you see for instructions. How to insert SIM, how to insert a memory card, like that. So you see instructions. Then if you see the instructions must be clear, understandable way. If the instructions are not clear, you cannot understand, you cannot work on it. So understanding instructions and giving instructions, both are important. So two things are there in this chapter. So suppose you have bought a smartphone pre-activity. You have bought a smartphone. You do not know how to use it. What will you do? Next question. Many gadgets come with a manual. How does a manual help us? The first one is, definitely you see manual book with the laptop or mobile or whatever you buy. The manual book will be there in the box, so definitely you refer manual. Next, many gadgets come with a manual. Many gadgets means electronic devices or something, someone else. So the devices come with a manual. How does a manual help us? Manual help us how to use it, how to operate, how to work on it. Just now what we discussed. Okay. Next, here is one activity. Read the following conversation between an examiner and the examinees and identify the instructions given. Here what you have to do is identify the instructions. Right. First, examiner. Have you received the OMR sheet? Examinees. Yes, we have. Examiner. Write your name and PIN in the space provided at the top. Examinees. Okay. Examiner. After that, take a pencil and fill the appropriate circles in box 5. Examinees. Okay. Next, examiner. Open the answer books now. Check whether it has all the questions or not. Do not write anything on the answer book. Use the blank sheets given to you to do rough work. Okay, right? Now, what you have to do is, you have to identify the instructions. Have you received the OMR sheet? Is it instruction? Yes. Next, write your name and PIN in the space provided at the top. Yes, this is also an instruction. Next, take a pencil and fill the appropriate circle in box 5. Right. Open the answer books now. Check whether it has all the questions or not. Do not write anything on the answer book. Use blank sheets given to you to do the rough work. So these are all instructions. Are you able to understand the instructions clearly? Yes. Right. Next. Here, while giving instructions, you have some rules. Why? You have to give properly instructions. You should not jumble the rules. That means, suppose how to open account in a bank. Suppose take the acknowledgement, fill the application form, ask the help desk receptionist to open application form to open the account book. Are you able to understand? Here, I have given instructions not properly. That means take the acknowledgement of application. That means after submitting the application, take the acknowledgement receipt. But this is the last instruction. But I said in the first, at the beginning. So is it correct way? No. If I give the instructions in that manner, others may not understand it. What is it? So instructions must be properly given, orderly manner. How to know order? How to give order manner? Yes, we have to use some orders related words. So here is the information. Instructions should be given step by step. Logical sequencing as to what is to be done first and what comes later is essential. All relevant facts and do's and don'ts should be specified. Use simple and direct language. Use imperatives. When a series of instructions are given, use expressions for sequencing, starting, continuing, and finishing. Use the following list to know some expressions used in instructions. So here is the instruction, a list of words, expressions used in instructions. Okay, leave it. First, what are the main points here I mentioned? Number one is, instructions should be given step by step. Right? Instructions how to be given step by step. Instructions should be given in a logical sequencing. That means what is to be done first and what comes later. And also relevant facts. What is that? Next, do's and don'ts. Do's and don'ts should be specified, what to do and what not to do, which is very important. And at the finally, use and direct language, not complicated, simple language and direct language. And also imperatives, open the textbook, close the textbook, write the complete the homework, like that, imperatives. When a series of instructions are given, use expressions of sequencing, starting, continuing, and finishing. So we have to use the expressions like sequencing, starting, continuing, and finishing. What are the sequencing words? What are the starting words? What are the continuing words? What are the finishing words? So here they are given. See, sequencing words. Firstly, then, next, lastly. What are the starting words? Before you begin, the first thing is, I would start by to begin with. Here, note that don't use all of them in the same place. Suppose if you use I would start by, then don't write the before you begin. Here, what I mean to say is that use any one in the beginning. You want to start the instructions. You want to start giving instructions. So you can start with any one of the given. Before you begin, or the first thing is, or I would start by, or to begin with. In English, you have so many words, so many sentences, so many expressions are there to explain, to express, to convey the meaning. So here are some given words or expressions are given. Next, continuing words. After that, the next step is to further, then. That means here, one instruction after another instruction. So between the instructions or among the instructions, use these words for continue to express the continuation. Next, finishing. At last, the last step is in the end, when you have finished, finally, in that manner. Next, activity 2. Observe the instructions are given to prepare a cup of tea. First, take half a cup of water in a kettle. Then, light the stove. After that, place the kettle on the stove. Boil the water in the kettle. Then, add a spoon of tea powder. Also, add half a cup of milk. Next, add a spoon of sugar. Let it simmer for 2 to 3 minutes. Then turn off the stove. Finally, filter the tea. Now, serve hot tea in a cup. See how the instructions are given. Instructions are given with the proper sequencing words. What are the sequencing words are mentioned in this activity 2? First, then, after, then, also, next, finally, now. So, you have to give instructions in this manner. In examination point of view, in 1 mark question, they ask you to write sequencing words, that means beginning words, how to give instructions, sequencing words. Give two express model expressions of starting. Give two model expressions of continuing. Give two model expressions of finishing. Then you have to write. Suppose the question is, give two instructions of sorry, to give to finishing expressions in giving instructions. Then you have to write the last step is in the end, or when you have finished, or finally, in that manner. If the question comes like give, write a model expression of continuing instructions, then you have to write after that, the next step is further, then in that manner. And in 3 marks and five marks questions, the question like this: give instructions how to prepare a cup of tea, write instructions how to use a coin operated telephone, in that manner. Maybe this question comes in 3 marks or 5 marks. Maximum 5 marks questions will come. So now arrange the following jumbled sentences in correct order. Write a paragraph with the sequences. Use expressions of starting, continuing, and finishing. Right. See. How to wash one's face. Dry your face with a towel. Take some water. Rinse your face. Remove the soap. Splash water on your face. Take some soap and apply it to your face. To wash your face, you require water and soap. See, are the instructions given in a proper order? Do you think we can do that using the given instructions? No, because they are not given in an order. We have to give right in order first. Then we have to use sequencing words and write in a paragraph manner. Okay. Right. Which one comes first? Which instruction comes first? Which instruction comes second? Total is 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 instructions are there. The first instruction is in the correct order. Seventh one comes first. To wash your face, you require water and soap. Next, second one comes. Take some water. Next, take some soap and apply it to your face. That means sixth one. Next, splash water on your face. Next, remove the soap. Am I right? Rinse your face. No. First comes rinse. Rinse your face. Next, remove the soap. Next, dry your face with a towel. Right. Now, you have to write in a paragraph manner using the sequencing words. So, you can begin like this. You should wash your face daily for 1 or 2 times. For this, you require water and soap. At first, take some water and splash on your face. The next step is to take some soap with fingers and apply it to your face. After that, rinse your face with fingers and apply it to your face after that. Remove the soap. Then last step is dry your face with a towel. Okay, next. Activity 3. Write what you want to say in the space provided. So questions are given like task A, task B, task like that. Okay, in this activity. First, so while giving instructions, remember that instructions should be clear, simple, and sequencing words must be used. Order we have to follow. Right, first one, instruct your partner on how to use a coin operated public telephone. Maybe most of you don't know what is coin operated telephone. Okay, maybe some of you still know that they are available in villages. I hope now also in cities they are not available. Right. I will explain model instructions. Firstly, lift the phone receiver. See the picture. Firstly, lift the phone receiver. Then insert a 1 rupee coin in that box. Dial the number after you hear the ringtone. Once the talk is over, then disconnect the call. Finally, place the receiver back on the holder. Finish. Here the main important thing is, if the question is 5 marks question, you have to write instructions at least 5. If the question comes in 3 marks category, you have to write instructions at least 3. Right, next B. Instruct your partner on the rules to be followed while crossing a road. So it is common to all. Generally, we cross the road every day. When you come to college, when you go to home, when you go to shop. Okay, how to cross the road? Model answer. Always walk on the footpath or on the safe side of the road. Okay, next, cross the road only at zebra crossing. While crossing the road, we should look our right, then left, and again look right. Then follow the traffic rules on the road. Cross the road only when it is clear. Okay, next, instruct your partner on how to draw money from an ATM. Model answer. First, insert your card into the ATM or swipe the card in the ATM. Then wait for the screen display to enter PIN. After enter PIN and press enter button. Then select the options to withdraw money Next, choose type of account and then enter the amount you want to withdraw. Finally, collect your money, slip and the ATM card. Finish. Okay. So you can write number of instructions. In examination point of view, the questions may come or may not come from these three or four examples. So different examples come, different questions come. How to use mobile, how to use a laptop, how to use how to ride a bicycle, how to take print from a printer, like how to wash face, there are some, how to switch on the fan, how to operate a TV. There are number of examples are there. So whatever it may be, you have to write in a simple manner, orderly manner, step by step, and you have to use sequencing words. That's enough. Next, common errors. Generally, pour means filling the bottle or a glass or whatever it is. Water pour, this is not right. Water is noun, pour is verb. Generally, we write subject, verb, object. So, pour water, we say pour water, not water pour. Next, vessel, take, then. No, generally, we use sequencing word first, then. Next, verb, subject, verb, object. So, then, take a vessel. Vessel means a bowl. Then take a vessel. Next, the stove light now. Not in order manner. We have to use sequencing word first. Now, subject, verb, object. Light the stove. Okay. Next, tips. Read manuals that come with phones, home appliances. Home appliances means washing machine, fridge, AC, like that. Note the instructions usually begin with the present form of the verb. Note that instructions usually begin with present form of the verb. That means simple present tense. Use please to make the instructions polite. To make your instructions polite, use please. Okay. Next assignments here. Write instructions for one of the following. Maybe you can write all. Opening a bank account. Taking a bus pass. Finding a word in a dictionary. How to prepare a recipe. In examinations, all these questions came previously. So, how important are these? You can understand. So, in your notebook, write all the answers, all complete the activities and assignments in your notebook. I will explain one model answer to opening a bank account. First, visit your nearest bank branch, then ask the help desk for an account opening form, then fill the form and attach a photo and enclose the documents needed, that means Aadhaar, some other driving license, ID proofs. Then finally submit the document and take the acknowledgement, like that. Suppose taking a bus pass, first visit your nearest bus depot. Then ask the help desk for a bus pass form, pay the prescribed fees, then fill in the details, attach photo and enclose a document, that means your bona fide certificate, ID card, something. Next, submit the form along with the required fees, then collect the acknowledgement in that way. Finding a word in a dictionary, you know, in the first sentence is there. How? First select the first alphabet of the word, then go to the alphabet page in the dictionary, then find the word on that page, in that manner. Okay, how to prepare a recipe? You can write it. Okay. So once again, go through the all the what I explained here. Listen it. Write the assignments and activities in your field notes. If you have any doubt, I will explain in our live class. Until then, I am closing this session. Thank you.